Hello students, good morning. I'm your teacher Dolcy and today we are going to start next topic from the chapter Human Reproduction and the name of topic is Major Functions of Male Reproductive System. Means what are the functions that are performed by male reproductive system? And as you know, the major function of the male reproductive system is the production of sperms. So that is said to be the spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis is the formation of sperms by the germ cells of seminiferous tubule. Second process is the production of male sex hormone, that is testosterone. And third one is the transfer of sperms from the male reproductive tract to the female genitalia. So these three criteria are necessary and are the functions of the male reproductive system. So now, next topic is the hormonal control in the male reproductive system. So as you all know, as we have studied in class 11th, that hypothalamus is the major mastermind of our body. It is the organ which controls all other organs of the body. For its hormonal action control, it controls the pituitary gland of human body, which is the master gland of the human body. That gland ultimately controls all other major organs of the body for their hormonal secretion. So hypothalamus is the mastermind which releases the hormone, that is GnRH, that is gonadotropin releasing hormone. So it is the hormone which stimulates the anterior lobe of pituitary to release two hormones, that are LH and FSH, luteinizing hormone and the follicle stimulating hormone. This hormone, the LH, is also known as ICSH, that is also known as ICSH, that is known as interstitial cell stimulating hormone. This hormone, LH, or the interstitial cell stimulating hormone, it stimulates the lady cells of the human testes to secrete the hormone testosterone that is produced in the male testes. And this hormone, this is the male reproductive hormone or male sex hormone, which ensures the reproductive growth of all the reproductive organs of human genitalia, male genitalia. Second hormone is the FSH, that is known as the follicular stimulating hormone. It stimulates the Sertoli cells or the nerve cells of the human testis present in the seminiferous tubules of the testis. This Sertoli cells, they undergo two kind of functions. First is it stimulates the spermatogenesis. Second, it inhibits the functioning of the reproductive tract by releasing an hormone that is known as inhibin. Okay, so the spermatogenesis is necessary secondary sexual characteristic. It is necessary for all the observing secondary sexual characteristics in human body. And the human hormone, inhibin hormone, it gives a negative feedback to both the anterior pituitary and hypothalamus to block or to suppress the synthesis of the hormone, because necessary characters are appeared during this secretion period. Then this inhibitory period inhibits the release of GnRH, gonadotropin releasing hormone, and luteinizing hormone from the pituitary. As you know, all know that testosterone is the male sex hormone. So it is necessary for all the secondary sexual and primary sexual characteristics observed in the human mole, whether it is spermatogenesis or whether it is the puberty characteristics in the male. Next is the Sertoli cells. The Sertoli cells secrete two kind of protein. First are the ABPs and second are the inhibiting proteins. ABPs are antigen binding protein, or they are activating in nature, while the inhibin protein is inhibitory in action. Activin protein or the androgen binding protein, AB protein, it concentrates the testosterone in the seminiferous tubule, while the inhibitin protein, it inhibits the or suppress the secretion of FSH hormone. The release of FSH, LH, ISH in turn are controlled by release of hypothalamic gonadotropin releasing hormone, GnRH. Means, as you know, the hormonal control is interlinked. द सिक्रेशन ऑफ वन कंट्रोल्स और रेगुलेट्स द सिक्रेशन ऑफ अदर. इन दिस वे द सुप्रेशन इन रिलीज ऑफ हॉर्मोन FSH LSH इन टर्न दे सुप्रेस द रिलीज ऑफ GnRH फ्रॉम द हाइपोथैलेमिक रीजन ऑफ ह्यूमन मेल. इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू कम्प्लीट द स्मॉल स्मॉल वेरी सिंपल टॉपिक्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर सो दैट नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल स्टार्ट अप विद द ह्यूमन फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम. बिकॉज वेन यू बिकम फेमिलियर विद द मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम इट इज नेसेसरी दैट यू गेट एन आइडिया वट आर द डिफरेंसिस बिटवीन मेल एंड फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम आफ्टर द कम्प्लीशन ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ वेरियस parts of the bodies of female reproductive system. Then we will start up with the events of reproduction. First is the gamete formation, then fertilization, ultimately the embryo formation and pasturation. Okay, so the next topic is puberty in human male. So what is puberty first? It is the period of sexual maturity when reproductive organs become functional. Whenever the reproductive organs means the testes and the other external genitalia, they become functional, that stage is said to be the puberty. And it is said to be the attainment of sexual maturity, means the human males become sexually mature. In male, puberty is characterized by onset of spermatogenesis. Men means when the formation of sperms start in the testes of human male, that stage is said to be the puberty. And the period or the age for onset of puberty in human male is 13 to 16 years. So which hormone is responsible for controlling the puberty in the human male is the testosterone, the male sex hormone, that is testosterone, which is secreted by the Leydig cells of the human testes under the secretion of LSH secreted by the anterior lobe of a pituitary. Next are the characteristics of puberty that are observed at the time of puberty in human male are the seminiferous tubules start producing human sperm, the development and maturation of the secondary sex organ like prostate gland, scrotum and penis starts, the development of secondary sexual characteristics like the growth of hair on face in the form of beard and mustaches, the chest hairs, the pubis hair, the axillary hairs, the broadening of shoulders, the deepening of voice means the pitch of the voice of human males is lower than that of the female, and the enlargement of voice box in the form of Adam's apple, the increase in height due to rapid growth in the human bones, and the increased musculature is observed in the human male. So these are the primary characteristics that are observed at the onset of puberty in human male. And these characteristics retain throughout life of the human male after attainment of sexual maturity. So, as I am showing you the learning plus, these are those questions that you will definitely get during your NEET examination. So, first point here is the differentiation of testes is controlled by HY gene of Y chromosome. As you know, the Y chromosome is the shortest chromosome of human 23 pair of chromosomes. This chromosome usually carry only 107 genes. Out of those, all the genes are necessary for the maleness. No any other functional somatic gene is found on the Y chromosome. Out of those genes, the HY gene is known for the differentiation of testes, means making testes functional. Second are the male accessory ducts, whether they are at a testis or vas efferentia, epididymis, vas deferens or urethra, all these ducts have tendency to store and transport the sperms from testis to the outside of the body through the urethra or penis. Third point is the Sertoli cells, which provide nourishment to the growing sperms, were reported by, who reported these cells? An Italian histologist known as Enrico Sertoli. Hence the name are Sertoli cells. Actually, they are nursing cells which provide nourishment to the growing sperms. Next point is the interstitial cells. They are Leydig cells, were discovered by a German anatomist, means who studies the anatomy, is the French von Leydig. Hence, the name of interstitial cell is Leydig cell. Next are inguinal hernia. It is a kind of disorder that occurs due to descending of an intestinal loop into the scrotum. When the loop of intestine, it descends into the scrotum, a disease is observed in the human male, that is said to be the inguinal hernia. Next, accessory genital glands along with their duct system and the penis, they collectively known as secondary sex organ, means the organs which are not producing sperm itself, all other are known as secondary sex organs. Next term is datus muscles of scrotal sac wall and the cremator muscles of spermatic cord. They help in changing the position of testes. The contraction of cremator cells move the testes closer upward toward the body, which provide little more warmth to maintain the optimal testicular temperature. Means in the walls of scrotum, certain muscles are present which have tendency to change the position of the testes by contraction and relaxation. When the temperature of the scrotal sac it rises, it descends the testes below the body so that the temperature reduces and the sperm can grow. Whenever the temperature of the body is high and whenever the temperature of body is low, it contracts the muscle and it stretches the testes toward the abdominal wall so that more heat is absorbed by the testes to keep the sperm warm as much they require. Last point is the prostatitis. As you know, itis word is for swelling, so it is the swelling of the prostate gland. So the enlargement of prostate gland and is characterized by difficulty in urination. When you feel difficulty in urination means to release urine, and the enlargement of prostate gland is observed, that time that disease is said to be the prostatitis. Next is from the competition plus file, that we have 3 points here. First is Sertoli cells. Sertoli cells secrete an hormone known as anti-Müllerian hormone. This hormone is necessary to suppress the development of female duct system. Let me explain this. So, as you all know, that Sertoli cells secrete a hormone that is anti-Müllerian hormone. This hormone is necessary. It is very necessary to suppress the development of human female system. So, whenever a male carry even the Y chromosome, even if the anti-Müllerian hormone is unable to work, then the testes will not differentiate in that male, and that male with the Y chromosome will not be an efficient male to reproduce, because the gonad in that human being will be the ovaries. As you know, the complementarity between the Y chromosome and ovaries is not there, that will not be functional, but the gonads are said to be the testes, not the ovaries, if the anti-Müllerian hormone is not functional in the human male during the gestation period of human reproductive system. Okay. Next is testes develop from intra-abdominal mesodermal urinogenital region. Means if someone asks you where the testes develop, that is said to be the intra-abdominal, means from internal of the abdominal mesodermal, means middle layer of urinogenital ridges. You have to memorize all the 4 words: intra-abdominal, mesodermal, urinogenital ridges, from where the testes develop. Last term is cryptochoroidism. Have you heard about this? Cryptochoroidism, it is the failure of testes to descend into scrotal sac. Sometimes, as you all know, testes during the gestation period first grows in the abdominal region. Then at the last trimester, they descend into the scrotal sac. Sometime due to some kind of disorder that is said to the cryptochoroidism, these testes are not able to descend into the scrotal sac. In that case, that male is said to be the sterile, because as you know, scrotal sac is necessary to maintain a low body temperature for the development of the sperm. If that low temperature is not maintained, then sperms will not develop, and the male is said to be the sterile. So These all are the topics with the, related with the male reproductive system, and with this, all the necessary points related to the male reproductive system get completed. If you have any doubt about any of the part of the male reproductive system, you can ask. And in next lecture, we will discuss about the structure of female reproductive system in detail. Then you have to draw the diagrams of male reproductive and female reproductive system as well on your fair notebook. Then will be your test, and ultimately will be your Zoom class for your doubts. And then we will start the actual phase of reproduction to undergo the fertilization with the formation of gametes. That's all for today. Thank you.